Yo, what's up everybody? Jumpin' here, and I am back with my Noob's Guide for Elden Ring. In the last episode, we finished up the bottom portion of this map, and we did the side castle. Now it is finally time to go and do Stormveil Castle. This is our very first main castle of the game, and there's a lot to do there. Now I went ahead and I popped all of my golden runes. I'm going to do the same with these. I'm just going to use selected, that way I can level up a little bit. I'm trying to get my dex up to 30. That is the goal right now. So let's go ahead and level up. And I'm just going to focus on dexterity. And now I'm going to make my way over to the castle. There is going to be a scarab along the way, but we are starting at the Stormhill Shack, and it's really easy to get there. Just follow the road. There's some enemies over there where those trees are and the bushes. We used that path before to actually cut to get to a bridge and then to take like a shortcut over to the lake area. But now this time we're going this way and just following the road, and we can make our way over to the actual castle. And we can also fight the very first real boss of the game. Now I always kind of say the real bosses will have cutscenes. If they don't have a cutscene, they're not one of the major bosses. And this guy has a cutscene. So once you come into this tunnel, there will be a grace, so let's go ahead and like that. And I'm probably being chased, and I am, so I'm going to rest real quick. Now, there is an NPC we can summon for this fight. You don't have to summon him. He does have a little bit of a quest line, but I don't think it affects it if you don't summon him. I'm going to summon him, but just know that the fight's going to be a little bit harder because the boss is going to have more health, and we're not going to be able to use our ashes, our wolves, as a summon. That would make the fight a lot easier. Being able to use those ashes, we would just dominate. Now let's go ahead and use golden vow, that way we can just buff up our guy. I'm gonna use an FP potion, why not, and we're gonna use our mixed potion, and let's do this. Let's go and kick this guy's ass. Now the very first thing is let's just kind of run up to him. Whenever we feel like we can do a hit, we're just gonna do our ash of war, and outside of that I'm just blocking and looking for an opportunity. Now because I have the co-op in here, every time he starts hitting them, it's going to distract this guy. And that's good for me because it gives me some free hits. Now the moment he gets up, I'm just going to smack him again and again, and there we go. Really, really easy. He didn't even get his hammer attack off. But the main thing that we get for doing that is a talisman pouch. So now we can equip another talisman, and that's nice. So let's do that right now. Out of every one of the talismans that I have, I think the one I'm probably going to just put on is the green turtle talisman, because it's going to give us more stamina recovery, which is good if you're playing with like a melee build. Stamina recovery is really important. We can probably level up again, I'm going to check, but let's just go ahead and light the grace, and we can rest at it, and let's try to level up. So dexterity, and we are good. Now, we can open up this main gate here. I don't recommend going this way because it's pretty much death. I mean, we're so strong, we can make it through, no problem. But you can actually have the guy open it for you now. But we will be going back around, so I'll probably just go around. But it's alright to have him open it for you right this moment. It's not a problem. But right here next to the grace, if we kind of come over this way, there's a staircase we can go down. And there is an item. Let's pick up the item. And if you look over there, you can actually see there's a little drop off. So we're going to walk off and we're going to go this way. And this is going to lead to another item. So let's pick this one up. Now, I don't think there's anything down here. It looks like there would be something down here, but there's not. So it's like, okay. Well, technically, I guess there is that. There are crafting materials, but that's basically about it. Let's go this way. This is going to take us back to where the grace is, and then we can go and talk to this guy. And like I said, it's up to you on what you want to say to him. If you want him to open the gate now, you can, but I just don't really recommend going that way. I don't think I lit this grace. This is one of those moments where it's kind of dumb because you kill the boss and then there's a grace. You run like 20 feet forward and then there's another grace. What's the point of that? I don't really know, but okay. Let's go ahead and now talk to the guy real quick And then I'm just going to probably say I'll take the side route. Now, this guy does sell stuff. He is a merchant. And when you come back here later, you can buy stuff. But then at that point, once you beat the actual boss here, you can't talk to him again. Or at least you cannot actually buy stuff from him. I know that they did update his quest, I guess. And they made it so that you can get something from him later on in the game. So maybe at that point, you can buy the rest of his stuff. I'm just not sure yet. So keep that in mind. But right over here to the left, we can go ahead and hit this. And also, this is a summoning pool. You can always activate these if you want, because this is how you would normally summon people. You're gonna have to jump up here. And this part kind of sucks. Even though we're really OP, I still hate this because I hate these birds. These birds are so annoying. So the very first one is just up there. I hate these things. We're going to see several of them in this castle. And let me tell you, they're just awkward to hit. Even though I'm going to one-shot them. But my main thing is just block them and then just R1. Because I'm telling you, they are awkward to hit. Now, this is another one of those spots where it's very weird. Because you would think there would be an item up here where that bird was. If we come up here and we look around, yes, we can pick this up. Thank you. But that's about it. Now, there is a grace down there, but we're going to go get an item first. Technically, you could go get the grace right away if you want. But from this angle, though, you can actually take out one of these dumb birds right away. So there's the bird. I'm just going to do a jump R2 and hope I hit it. Yes, I did. Nice. Now, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to block, and then I'm going to try to R1, and it works pretty good. Pick up that. It's just crafting materials. Now up here, this is kind of annoying because it's a trap. There are three birds. Oh boy. Now the very first one, we can definitely rush and try to take him out before he flies. This one, I'm going to try to do my block R1. But you see, when there's two of them, it's very annoying. Trust me, I have really hated these birds. When you're not OP and you have like a weak weapon and it takes multiple hits, those birds are just annoying. I'm also going to make it day, because right now it is night, so I don't like that. You know how it is. And right back there, there was a smithing stone. That's what I picked up. But we are going to go ahead and hit the grace. And again, there is another summoning pool, so you can activate that if you want. And I'm going to go ahead and make it day. So let's go ahead and do that. Just need to pass the time. And we are going to make it noon. Morning is kind of annoying too, because a lot of times in the morning it's really foggy or it's raining. I don't like that either. Now there's a guy up here. He's going to call his allies if he sees you. If you do a little stealth, you can sneak up on him. And if you have any range, you can also do that to go ahead and take him out with range before he can call. But it doesn't really matter because we can just literally block. Try to build him up. Try not to walk off the cliff. That's the only thing. And I'm doing that. Come on down. Come on down. Now, all my attacks should one-shot these guys. I really don't need to do the Ash of War. But the Ash of War actually has some nice AoE to it. Now, over here, there is an item, but there's a guy up there. He's going to chuck a firebomb at you. That will definitely happen. You can bait it out, though. If you just kind of run in here, wait for the firebomb, pick it up, run back, and you should be good. And, of course, he still hits me. Oh, my God. Now, these guys, they are really close to one another, so an AoE should take them out no problem. Now, this can be death, depending on your health. So what you want to do is go up the steps, let these guys chuck the firebombs, and blow up those barrels. If you have, like, lower health and you try to run up there and they blow you up, it does kill you. There is kind of a bigger guy over here, but we're so strong we should be able to just do a running R1 and take him out. There is an item, but it's some claws, which I don't like. But that's basically it when it comes down to what's down on the bottom here. Now we need to rush those guys with fire bombs. So let's just go ahead and block, and I'm going to run in. Oh, hello, he was actually trying to get me. Well, that's cool. Watch out, there's more exploding barrels, which are annoying. Take him out. Now this door over here is locked, but be careful because I have seen it before where people have literally walked off the edge right there, not being able to see that it's a drop off. So up here, the first thing we can actually do is go get that item over there. just to save a little bit of time. It's very easy. Just do a sprint and a jump, and now we can pick it up. No problem. Boom. Now, there is an item down that's kind of... Ooh, why am I overweight? Oh, wow. Oh, okay. I'm overweight because I put the talisman on. That's amazing. Well, for now, I'm just going to take the dagger off, and I need to level up endurance once. That's crazy. So there is this item here. Be careful because technically we can wait. I'm going to say let's wait, but you can bait out the firebomb attack and blow up all the barrels. But there's another way we can go, which is over here. So there's the staircase. Just jump on up here. There's going to be some enemies down here. So the first one, let's lock on and just jump and R2. Take him out, no problem. Now this one, and there's another one above. He's going to chuck a firebomb. Let's just R1 him. And this can be a little annoying. We have to wait for this guy to come down. Sometimes he actually just sits on the ladder. Don't ask me why. It happens. It's really annoying when it happens. But now we can climb up the ladder. And we can actually go this way. And this is going to come up behind this guy right here. The one who was throwing the firebombs. So now we don't have to worry about him at all. Let's go get this item. It's perfectly safe now. And again, it's my favorite item in the game, the stupid butterfly. You get that all the time. It's really, really trolly. So I'm just looking over here because I see all these messages. It makes me think there is an item, but there's not. Now, there was that enemy who rushed me, but normally he's just sitting right here. So a lot of times you can just come up behind him and just take him out, no problem. Now, coming up in here, there is going to be a stronger enemy. Now, it's really awkward and weird. I actually would recommend maybe putting the lantern on before we actually go in. Just because it's really dark in here. Now, this guy should be pretty easy for us to deal with because we're so OP. I want to say one Ash War might take him out, but I'm not sure yet. So, I'm going to try to let him do something first. And then when I get an opportunity, I'm going to go for the attack. And, of course, he blocks it. You got to watch out. They have these crazy wind attacks. So, my follow-up was able to take him out. But he will like shield bash with this wind attack, and it's quite annoying, and it will stun you. So right there, there is the key that we need for that one door, and there is a chest in here, so we're going to open this up, and we're going to grab the item. Which that item, that talisman, will improve your guard counters, which is not bad. Definitely not bad. Now the door was closed because that was like a trap, but now we can just literally come down this way, hop on down, here's the door, let's open it up. And now we need to climb this ladder over here. Now, coming up over here, there is a path that we can take to basically get a couple items. And there's also going to be kind of a trap. So let's deal with the trap first, just to be done with that. The trap is right around this corner. It's to our left. So just get ready to swing. He's going to try to grab you. I think if he grabs you from the front, you're okay. But if he grabs you from behind, he will backstab you. So make sure you make that jump there. It's hard to see that that's a jump, but it is a jump. Watch out for the firebombs. Now we can rush this guy and take him out. But trust me, I've seen that too a lot, where people will not know it's a jump and they will just walk right off. It won't kill you, I don't think. Let me look. Yeah, that's not going to kill you, but it's annoying because then you have to go and climb back up the ladder. So there's an item right there and you're thinking, how do you get that? Well, we're going to get it in a minute, but for now we can't get it. But there's also this little path over here that we can jump to. So that's what we're going to do now. We're just going to jump over here. There will be some enemies over here as well. So be ready for that. And the guy has a shield. So I'm going to go ahead and try to guard counter him. And he's trying to shield bash me. That does the most stamina damage to me. And now this guy just has a crossbow. So that's pretty easy. Pick up his item. You're going to get a little annoyed, by the way. Because there are so many of those guys, you're going to end up getting a ton of their armor. But right here, we can pick up this weapon. And now we're pretty much good. Unfortunately, we have to drop down. And we also will have to go ahead and climb back up the ladder. But hey, I was able to pick that item up. Nice. So let's go ahead and hop down. Now we can climb up the ladder. And there is so much stuff in this castle, it's crazy. It will blow your mind. Now, to be honest, I think this is probably the best castle in the entire game, just for everything that it has. But they did a really good job with this place. There are so many paths you can take. It is crazy. So many little hidden items to get. I mean, it's insane. I love it. I absolutely love this castle. But we just got that item over there. Now, there will be an item before the staircase if we just kind of hug the wall here. Again, there are a lot of messages. Even though a lot of those messages are trolly and they'll tell you to jump off or to attack the wall, a lot of times when you see a message, it's not a bad idea to go and read it. And I don't know why cars are so loud around here. I don't know if you could hear that, but man, there's some loud cars, so sorry about that. If you come this way, there is no item. But again, you're going to be able to see that, you know, a lot of times people will put a message down to let you know that it's a waste of your time. Now, this guy is kind of scary, but he's real easy. We can get a free backstab on him, no problem, by just sneaking up behind him. I don't know if this is going to kill him. It's not, but just hit him once, and we're good. But he does try to always stomp when he gets back up. So if he stomps on you, it's a little annoying. Now, to be honest, to save a little bit of time, what I kind of recommend, now you can't do this if you're playing in co-op, but if you just go up the steps, there's a grace in here, which is obviously very, very important. But let's go ahead and hit the grace. But now let's go get this one item, but then we can just fast travel back to the grace. If you don't fast travel, you do have to go all the way back around. It can be a little bit annoying. There is an item on the other side, but we'll wait on that one. But let me just show you. So right here, we can actually walk off, and it's safe. So walk off, and now we can go ahead and come down this way. And remember that one item? Well, we can go get that now. So just go ahead and jump to this little wood place and pick it up, and we're good. We have gotten every item from this first little half. So now I'm going to fast travel back to this place, the Rampart Tower. I'm going to cut this ahead. I'm going to see you guys in a moment. Alrighty, now before we actually go back this way, we're going to go outside because I hate this spot out here. I really do. But the thing is that we only ever have to come out here once. Again, there's the annoying birds, but this time they have exploding barrels. So they are just really annoying now. But what we can do is equip our bow. Now we bought this before, the short bow. Let's equip it. And I'm going to switch to it. I'm going to two-hand it. So I need to hold triangle and press R1. Now another thing is, as we've been exploring the world, we have been getting some fire arrows. So make sure you have some fire arrows equipped and you can aim with L1. And let's just shoot the barrel with the fire arrow and boom! No more stupid birdie. Same with this one over here. Just go ahead and aim in, shoot that barrel, and he's dead. And there's another one to our left, but you can hit it from this angle over here. And there we go. And there's just one more annoying bird to deal with. And by the way, later you can do the same thing, but we're not probably going to do it later. But there's a bunch of barrels over here. I don't think it matters which one you hit. But right there, we just took out another bird. And let's unequip it because we don't want to be fat and have a fat roll. And pick up the item. There we go. Yay! Don't have to deal with those annoying birds. Now we can come down these steps. Now there is an item like right here. And there's another item that we need to drop down to. But the main thing over here is an NPC that we need to talk to. Remember that sorcerer guy that we summoned? Well, now we can actually talk to him. So there's a ladder over there. We're gonna walk off right here, and there is an item, so let's pick it up. And now we can actually just go through the window, and we can get right to the sorcerer dude and talk to him. Make sure you talk to him fully. You can buy some spells from him, but he will go to the round table. He actually has another thing here as well, but say the first thing. I really don't think it matters what you say to him though, to be honest. But just go through the whole dialogue. And if you want to buy some spells, you can. I need to get some experience so I can get my endurance up. But over here, there's going to be a couple enemies. I really don't think there's anything out here. If you want to take them out, you can. I don't really think it matters, though. But there is one of these knight enemies, the banished knights. Now, if you want to be real smart, and I would recommend this, you can crouch and just wait for him to turn around and run up and try to get a backstab on him. Or you can just be Leroy Jenkins and just run in and just do this. Boom. Boom. It worked. It worked good. Now just take this stupid guy out. And there we go. Now I want you to remember this spot because this is important, but there's an enemy down there, and if I look back this way, there's the ladder going up, because we will be coming back over here, and I'm going to bring it up later. So just remember where we are, because what we're going to do is we are going to go ahead and climb up this way, and we are going to go to a little secret area. Now, this was the final little secret spot that I found in this castle. There's an elevator, and I always wondered, like, how do you get to this elevator? Well, I finally figured it out, like, a couple days ago, I guess. And I was, like, super happy about it. I was like, finally, I found the last thing. But basically, remember where this bird was that we shot? Well, there's some crates here. If we jump up here, we can look off and boom, just walk off. And now we're down here. Now, this spot has a lot of these. Like, there would definitely be an item over here, right? Nope. Very strange. You would think they would put something back there. But there is an item up there. We can see it. So just walk off here and hug the wall. And we can just run on over here. Hop on down and pick up the item. And that's a shield. Now drop down. Again, you would think maybe there'd be an item down here somewhere. Nope. Nothing. Very weird. And once you're down here, you're like, where do I go? You might look off the edge and go, oh, okay. I just gotta hop down there. Well, let's go ahead and hop down. Oh my god! Okay. The moment you hop down, though, there is a scarab, so make sure you take out the scarab. But yeah, gravity in this game, very strange. I don't even know why they would do that. I just don't get it. Because even if, yes, technically, I did hit the rocks or whatever that was, right, and I fell through, I still would have died to gravity. I still would have broken, like, every bone in my legs. I don't really understand, like, what difference does that make? Now, up here, that's a crucible knight. Kind of scary. Remember, they're not fun. Now, you can't backstab them, which is kind of disappointing. But if you want to be smart about this, wait for him to get into the corner. Now, the moment he gets into the corner, we can get a sneak attack on him. So, let's do that. Because if we rush up behind him, we can actually just do our Ash of War. And then do the follow-up. And he's done. Easy peasy. Pick up the item. He drops a spell as well. But if you don't do it that way, you do need to kind of wait for him to attack because he is very aggressive. And the best time to always attack the Crucible Knights is when they do their little stomp and their two-hand attack. That's the best time. Now, again, you would think, item over here. Nope. And again, you might think, well, maybe there's an item over here. Nope. There's nothing. It's just strange. There might be a crafting material. But yeah. We can hit the elevator, and now we can go back up top. You can just see a guy who fell down. That's something that happens a lot, where people are trying to figure out how to get down here. And once we're all the way back up to the top, we can actually get this one item. We've seen this earlier. We can pick it up now. And again, we're going to go to another little secret spot. So we're going to run up the stairs now. There is a guy right here. I'm going to try to take him out. And there is a crossbow guy behind us. Now, this might seem a little scary, but it's real easy. Just jump like that. Oh my god. Hopefully he doesn't kick you, though. But the item over here is extremely disappointing. And trust me, the first time I did this castle, I actually jumped to where the ropes are. And I jumped across. And I made it. I did make it. I killed the guy. I got the item. And I was like, oh my god, that's disappointing. And then guess what? I didn't make it back. I fell and I died. But this jump over here, if you do it this way, really easy. Really not a problem. Okay, if you actually go left here, we might be able to sneak up behind this enemy. Not that it matters. He's real weak. I believe he's a crossbow guy, so let's just check him out. Okay, where the hell is he? I guess he's outside. Uh-oh, that's not good. Where is this enemy? Oh, there he is. Okay, he's just chilling in the corner. A lot of times, he's actually, like, over there. Oh, watch out. This isn't good. Okay, good. I thought it wasn't going to be good. Because when you are quick about this, you can sneak up like this behind that guy up there and take him out. If he sees you, he might blow the horn. If he does, all these enemies are going to get up and try to kill you. Which shouldn't be a problem, but there is a lot of them. So now we can actually kill them all. Because they're just all sleeping and resting. Take them all out. And there is a secret out here. So what we need to do is, you see where the sandbag is? You can actually, like, walk up and get onto the ledge. You don't even need to jump. Now we can come over this way, and we're going to jump over there. So just get ready. You want to sprint, and you want to jump. Now we can go ahead and hug the wall and go around. Now we're inside. We can drop down. There is an item in here. Let's pick that up. And I hate these birds, but I really hate these blackbirds. Now, if you want to take this guy out real easily, if you look at the wall like this, if you press circle, you'll backstep, and then just hit R2, and you should take him out, no problem doing that. So go ahead and pick that up, and there is an item over here, and there are several things that we need to get, so let's grab that, which is an emote. The first thing we're going to do is actually just hop up here, so hop up, and then we're going to jump over there, so just jump on over, and again, just hug the wall. I'm trying to take my time doing this, but normally I would try to hug the wall and sprint. I just want you guys to be able to see properly. Now over here, just jump on up. There's an item on this dead body. It's a Spit Fiend Stone. We need those because we will be upgrading this great shield that we will be getting. And trust me, it makes a big difference. So we're gonna go ahead and hop on down, and now we can go that way. Or we can go up. We're going to go up first because this is actually like the wrong way to go. Again, just hug the wall. And there are like several enemies over here. The first one is to our right. So just do the sprint. Run behind over here. And now just get ready to take out all the crossbow guys. Oh my god, ow. There's still another one. He actually hopped down. Come here. Die. And I mean, look at this. They drop their armor and, well, I guess they just drop items in general a lot. But you will get, like, their armor. You will definitely get their armor. But now we can climb up the ladder. And up here, there's going to be a bunch of birds. If you want to try to take some of them out, you can, because they do drop crafting materials. But mainly, we're just going to get this talisman, which I really like this talisman. It gives you more damage for your jump attacks, and I love jump attacks. But I know that this is actually considered to be one of the worst talismans in the whole game. Now, this is pretty high up. Normally, I would say just walk off. But let's slide down because we don't really want to walk off. And another thing, too, you can make that jump to that other tower. But there's nothing over there besides a bunch of birds if you want to kill them for the crafting materials. Now, again, let's hug the wall. This is important. You really don't want to fall off coming up over here, because I'm pretty sure it should be death. Now, you can probably fall off right there, and you could use that as a shortcut, but we're not going to. But instead, we are just going to hug the wall, keep hugging it, and eventually you're going to see some enemies below you, and that's where we're trying to go. There's a bridge right there. Here are the enemies, so we're just going to walk off here, and you can get a backstab, or you can do this little strat where you just run in and do your Ash of War. Works like a charm. Let's go ahead and restore our FP. And honestly, I'm going to chug. Now, you might be tempted if you run and you're exploring. I do recommend exploring as you're following my guide, by the way, if you are. But there is an item down there. Don't drop down there. We will be getting that item. Don't worry about it. But let's go ahead and come over here. Now we can cross the bridge. There's going to be some more enemies, but we should be able to take them out. No problem with our sprinting attack. And this guy has a shield. Take him out. Now let's go get the item up here. Grab that. And it's a cookbook. Nice. Now here's a ladder where you can definitely just walk off. You don't need to slide down. You're not going to take any damage from that. There are a couple enemies though, so let's rush them. Take them out. This one too, take him out. And now, this part can be a little annoying. There's two banished knights, and you can't backstab them, but you can sneak up on them, and we're just gonna do the whole little Ash of War thing. So just run up on them, Ash of War, do the follow-up, easy peasy. Now this one, he's gonna come flying at us, so just block, and now we can counter with our Ash of War and our follow-up, and he just dropped an item. Thank you very much. Ooh, a double drop. Nice. Now we're going to come over here, pick up the item, and we will drop on down. And the first time I came down here, I really felt dumb because I thought that was a giant bird. I was super scared, but it's a flag. Oh boy, let's go ahead and pick up that item. Now, what's nice about this spot is we can actually come behind all these guys on these ballistas. I should have actually brought this up before. If you open the main gate, you can go that way, but there's all these guys who are going to shoot you on these ballistas, and they can kill you. You can get through it by dodging and, like, juking them, but it can be tough. Now, you might notice this as well. We need to actually use a stone key on the other side to open this up, which is also not bad because what we can do is if we ever do need to come over here again, we can actually just take that path to get over here and deal with these guys. Because trust me, trying to run from that main gate is always annoying. Even if you're like really high level, it's annoying. So make sure you drop here on the left first and take this one out because a lot of people might just drop down. You don't want to miss that one on the left. And now we can hop down, take this dude out. Same with him. And this one. There's a lot of enemies in here. Trust me, it's really annoying. But let's go ahead and pick that up. And there's another item, but watch out. There should be an enemy trying to get us, like, right away. Where's he at? No, there he is. He was another one. So, wow, there's, like, five guys on the ballistas. That's crazy, right? Take him out. Now we got this guy trying to come up to us. I'm just going to swing. Why not? Now, before we actually deal with these enemies, and there's a lot of guys with crossbows. A lot of them. So you're going to get hit here for sure. Let's run over here and open the gate. So if you don't have the guy open the gate for you, you can just run over here. And there is a grace in here as well. Kind of a pointless grace, though, because if you're trying to run like from here, you're going to get shot by those ballistas still. You just will. Now, you can make it easier from here, but still, it is a pain in the ass. Grab that item over there. But you can drop down and talk to this guy now, and he should actually sell you stuff, and he will be a merchant. So, there are things you can buy from him. Like, that's nice for the item discovery. If you're playing co-op, you can buy some of those. That's for invasions. The buckler's not a bad shield for a parry shield. So, yeah, there's some stuff. But it's up to you if you want to buy anything or not. I'm not going to waste my experience right now. But let's pick up all these items here. And we can now start dealing with all these enemies as well. So I'm just going to try to rush them for the most part. But like I said, there's a lot of crossbows. And you're going to get hit here for sure. So just rush. Take them out. They drop so many items. It will blow your mind. But a lot of them are mushrooms. Watch out. Get on. Look at all these crossbows. My god, leave me alone. All of you, die. My stamina's running out. There we go. Think I got them all. I mean, there are still more. Nope, of course. There was another one. How many was that? Like six guys with the crossbows? My god. Crazy, right? Well, there's a group of enemies over here. We can take them out real quick, but there's also like a mini boss. Now, I even myself will get confused when I say mini boss because a lot of times when I might say mini boss, I am saying a field boss. An enemy that actually has a red health bar like a boss. But at the same time, there are certain enemies that don't respawn and they're big enemies. And you could technically say that they are mini bosses as well. And there is one over here. I don't really know what to call these. I want to say the field bosses should be called field bosses. These are called mini bosses. I don't know. But this guy will be easy. As long as you can get an attack off, you should be able to take him out with two of your Ashes of War. No problem. And he drops some stuff. He doesn't respawn. Now, you can actually go over here where there are these guys with the statues and the halberds, and there is a grace over here. Now you want to remember this spot. I'm even going to open up my map to show you the map, because remember this spot, because once we beat the actual boss here, we can come back and actually activate the great rune, and we need to go this way. So this is the tower bridge. Try to remember that, and we will be going to get our great rune once we beat this boss. But the first thing I'm going to probably do is go get my plus 10 weapon. I think that's more important. Now, let me just take a quick look over here, because I really don't remember. Is there an item over here? I don't think so. Same with, like, where the lion guy was. I don't think there's an item over there where he was. But I just want to double check. Okay, no, there's not. This part coming up is kind of annoying. You should probably not die In fact, I would say this is not a bad time to chug our mixed potion. We have the shield, we have the health regen. Now, if you try to run up those stairs, you're going to get shot by crossbows. But if you actually jump up over here, you can take those guys out. There is an item up here as well, but there's really only one. So once you hop up, oh, of course he hit me. I should have waited, maybe. But the first guy's over there. You can see him right now. And the moment I try to do this jump, I'm going to get shot. I just know it. So, oh, God. And I missed, and I got shot anyway. Awesome. Didn't take too much damage, though. But let's take that dude out. Hop back up, and we're going to try again. The annoying part is, if you had some range, some proper range with proper damage, this would be easier. But just jump across. Oh, my God. It's so annoying. Try again. You can probably bait out this attack. Now that the enemy is gone, though, I'm happy. I could take my time. The enemy chucking the fire bombs at me is very annoying. In fact, you know what? I want to say I got a new strat. Let's jump this way. I think you can make that. Can I make that? No way. Okay, never mind. That's not a new strat. I thought for a second maybe I can make it to that. And if you could, you could easily get to that guy and he can't hit you. I'm going to try to bait out this attack. Come on, man, shoot. There we go. So if you can bait it out, you should be able to make the jump no problem. And now we can go and deal with this annoying guy. The only reason to come up here is for the item. It is important. It's a weapon. And we can go back up to get the other one. You don't need to, though. I don't think there's any item up there. It's up to you, though. Let's just go do it. There might be a crafting material, and I want to kill every enemy anyway. As a part of the walkthrough, I do think I should try to kill all the enemies. I think that will be kind of an important thing. But he didn't even shoot me. Yes, there is a crafting material up here. Let's pick that up. And he's dead! Wait, what? Did he die of a heart attack? I have no idea. Maybe the other guy shot him. That would be amazing if the other guy actually shot him. Oh, man. Awesome. Okay, well, whatever. Let's take out this guy. Now, this part coming up, we're going to run. We will be dealing with all these enemies, but not right now. There's just really no reason to do it right now. Same with all these items. Now, this first one, though, let's just take him out because we don't need to go back on the bottom anymore. And I guess with this one, too, let's take him out and grab this item. But then at this point, there's a lot of enemies coming up. A lot. This place is annoying. There's all these flamethrowers. It's crazy. So pick up those couple items. Now, we're just going to run and just jump over that tree. And we're coming in here. So the main thing is, once you get to where all the enemies are, just make a left and there's an open door. And if you're in a spot where there's a bunch of rats, you went the wrong way. That's the one thing to remember. Watch out for this guy. Take him out. And now we're going to come over here and get this one item. We are being chased by some enemies, which sucks, but whatever. We can go through this door. There is a big enemy in here. We want to ignore him for now. Just leave him alone. Don't even mess with him at all. But we are going to come over here, hit this elevator, and this is going to take us back up top where we can hit the grace. Whew, that was nice. But let's go and get the grace. I'm going to rest at it because I am going to reset the area. But also, I'm going to see if I can level up. I want to get that endurance. Give me that point in endurance so I can actually equip my dagger back. I want to be able to buff. Yes, I still have the medium load, so I am good to go. But let's go ahead and now take the elevator back down. Everything has reset, so that's cool. And the first thing we're going to do is actually go to the right. We can maybe sneak up on this big guy and take him out, but let's go to the right. And there's going to be some dogs in here, so let's just rush that one. I'm going to probably Ash War this one. And let's pick up this item. Pick this up, the Crimson Hood. That's a pretty good helmet. If you're looking for something really light, I kind of recommend that, especially in the early parts of the game. Let's now go over here to this door. And in here, is that one item. Remember I pointed it out up there? That's that item. But there's also this, which is a stone key. We can use that. And the main thing that's in here is a whetstone. We want to get that whetstone for our Ashes of War and our scaling and all that. So take that guy out. There's another one who's getting up, so let's rush him. And there's another enemy. You might actually remember this too, but he's around the corner, so just take him out. But remember I pointed him out? There's that ladder. We're not quite to that part. I said to remember that, but we're not quite there. Let's go ahead and pick all this stuff up in here. And now we can go and deal with that big guy. And he is really annoying. I'm actually going to buff. Just why not? And in fact, if you really want to, you can also use your mixed potion. No reason not to, because we're going to be resting at Grace's. We're going to be getting to them. So let's just go ahead and rush him and try to get our Ash of War off. And man, I hit him hard. And I took him out. Pretty easy. And because I had the bubble shield, I took no damage at all, which is nice. So let's pick up the rest of the items here. There's going to be a couple enemies sitting by this fire over here. So let's go ahead and take all of them out. And there's another item down there. There's a guy above us. So just be ready for him. Just going to go around up the stairs. Now that I have the health regen, it lasts for like 3 minutes. So, oh, it's nice. Very nice. Don't really have to worry about healing too much. I hate the shield. I really hate these guys with the shields. And I know it's crazy only because I'm using a shield and I'm doing the same stuff. Well, whatever. Okay, let's crouch down. And yes, we can get a sneak attack on this guy. Or we can just do this. I'm just doing that. Why not? Take him out. And we can go ahead and open up this chest that's in this room. I don't remember what's in here. Oh, the Mimic's Veil. Okay, that's a kind of cool, annoying item for PvP. But out here, what we're going to do is actually, we could go in here. I guess, nah, we're not. We're not going to go in there. We're going to actually do this first, which there is this sandbags. We can jump over this wall. And over here, there is an enemy. Wow, why is he aggroed? I guess he could hear me? I don't know. But there is an item out here. Let's pick that up. Now, let's go ahead and come around. And over here, that's where that knight was in that chest. But there is a ladder. Now, again, this is one of those spots. It's a little confusing because you would think there would be an item up here, right? Somewhere on the roof. In fact, you can even jump over here. And you'd think there'd be something here. Nope. But what the purpose is to hop down here. There is an enemy. So let's take him out. We can open up this door now. And that's a little shortcut. So, let's go ahead and come down this way. There is an enemy over here. And we can open up the chest. We can get the other item that's over there. Basically, there's one more thing. I'm going to go back and grab it. I actually thought this would connect to it. But I guess not. Oops, my bad. But let's go ahead and now go get that other item. Basically, if you remember, I talked about where that sorcerer guy was, the NPC we talked about. The main thing is I just don't want to deal with those birds on the top. I don't recommend you guys doing it either, like dealing with them. By doing all the things that we've been doing, we don't have to keep running through that area. Especially if you die. That's the really annoying part. If you keep dying or something, you have to run through that area. It's very, very annoying. But if we go this way, there's one more item, and it's in this room. So let's pick that up, and I'm just going to show you. But if you look, see, now we're back to where we were, where that ladder was and all that. So we are pretty much good. I think I'm going to go ahead and go back to the Grace and cut this ahead just because I need a little break. So I'm going to see you guys in a moment. Alrighty, well, I'm back at the Rampart Tower Grace. And I'm going to take the elevator. I'm going to have to call it back up. It's a good idea with these shortcuts to always send your elevator back up. Because if you die, you don't have to wait on it every single time. But I'm going to do that. So let's take it down. We're going to go out into that courtyard and deal with all of those enemies. And there's a ton of stuff to do out in that courtyard. It's crazy. So I'm sending that back up. We don't have to worry about that big enemy anymore down here. Look at all the creepy arms. It's so crazy. And look at that epic painting. Gotta love that. But now, if we just come over this way, this is going to take us back out into the courtyard. And there is a little bit of a strategy you can do to make it a little easier. The main thing is there's so many crossbow guys. It's insane. First thing is we can rush these dudes. And you can rush this one. Okay. Another thing you can do, if you're struggling, is run up these steps over here. And this will make them all chase you. There is an item up here. Ooh, and a big guy too. Take him out. And yeah, you can make them chase you up and try to take them out one at a time, which does work pretty well. And I'm just gonna rush this dude. I hate torches though. They're so good at like getting you and stunning you. And let's hop down. Look at this. So many dudes with crossbows. Oh my god. And they don't bounce off my shield, so that's just a little bit more annoying. But just keep moving, and you should be able to kind of avoid most of the crossbows if you keep, like, juking and moving. And, ow, when they pull out their swords, though, that's definitely annoying. Die! Let's back up and heal. You're gonna take some damage out here. There's no doubt about it. And just sneak up on him. You can backstab these guys, but it's kind of a waste of time. I think we're almost done. Okay. Yeah, we got all of them. So now we can just grab every item that's out here. There's a ton of them, so just grab them all in the middle. I might have to double check, but there we go. And there is a guy by this staircase. I think there's an item up there, so let's go get that real quick. And just look. And then we're going to go to where these rats are. So there was an item up here. Let's grab that. Wooden great shield. That's not the shield we're going to use. There's a much better great shield in this castle. And where we're going to go is now back kind of to where we came out over there. There is a staircase leading down over here. So there's going to be a bunch of rats down here, which of course the rats are annoying. But if you remember, I talked about there was a stone key that we could use earlier. Well, this is going to be that spot. Now, because we already got the grace and everything, we don't really have to worry about this so much. Oh my god, what's happened? They're dancing. But if you ever do want to get behind all these guys on the ballista, this is your easiest way of doing it. Because if you just go from that rampart tower grace, you can come down the elevator, come out in the courtyard, go to where these rats are, and if you have this opened up, which we're getting some stuff for faith, we got a prayer book, we got a seal, but if you have this open up, then you can just come over here and get behind these guys, take them all out. Very, very easy stuff. But now let's go back out in the courtyard, and we're going to be able to progress a little bit more. There's going to be a painting coming up, and there's also like some big enemies as well, but they shouldn't be too much of a problem. And there's also a statue. Now, this statue is one of these things that a lot of people might not get because they don't know how to break it. I talked about this before, but these statues that you have to break, you have to use a giant. And what's confusing, there is also a dog. I want to get the dog first. Come here, dog. What's confusing is you would think this big guy would be able to break it. So you might be sitting here trying to have him break it for you, and you're like, why is he not breaking it? He can't. That's why. He's not a giant. He might look like a giant, but he ain't a giant. So just take him out. And over here, there is the painting. So let's pick this up. And now let's go ahead and go back. And we will grab the item from the dog. Thank you. There's an item on the steps as well. And there is coming up a grace. But there's an item like all the way back here. Let's grab this first. You can drop down from here, but don't. Do not. There's no reason to. There's a better way of going. So let's just hit the grace. And there is an elevator, but we don't even need to take it, to be honest, because we're going to go around. So what we're going to do is, and this is a little bit annoying because we're coming from this angle, there's going to be these birds. And I do believe you might be able to actually shoot maybe an exploding barrel somewhere around here. But the same thing I'm going to do, I'm going to let them like attack me and then just R1. It works pretty well. There's also a guy with a crossbow coming up. So the bird is going to be on me, but I'm going to try to take him out first. Come here. Ah, why you got to kick me, man? There we go. Watch out for the bird. Come on, do something. Doesn't matter. I got him. So before we do anything, let's actually come up this staircase. There is an item over here. I believe there's an enemy hiding. So just get ready. Take him out. Now let's go ahead and grab the item. And we can go back. There's going to be a golden seed out here. There's an NPC. There's a lot of stuff out here. Let's do all of that before we trigger the giant. There is a giant, but we need to lure that giant all the way back to that statue to break it. So let's come in this room, and this is where the NPC is. Make sure you talk to her until she repeats herself. And she's going to say that she will help you with the boss. And you can summon her for the boss. You don't need to for her quest, but it's up to you. I probably will summon her, just because why not? But you don't need to. So I just talked to her a whole bunch. That way, for sure, she's going to show up for the boss. And now let's just grab, well, we just grabbed that item. And we're going to get the golden seed. And there's one more item that's in the corner. I'm also getting the crafting material. So over here in this corner, there is an item. Let's grab that. And now we can lure the giant over to us. I'm going to go ahead and chug too. So here comes the giant. The main thing is the giant does have like some range attacks, which is a little bit annoying. But these guys are also chasing me, so I'm trying to take them out. Ow! There we go. Oh, hello! He's on me good. But just keep running back. Make sure he follows you. You have some cover if he's trying to do his range attacks. But he breaks basically everything along the way. Hello! Go down the steps. Come on. Oh, there's the range attack. Okay. Come on. Don't do it no more. Just chase me. Down here. There we go. And just let him, like, walk towards this thing and it should break. The moment it does, start attacking his legs. There it is. And a couple hits on his legs and he should fall over. And of course he's just gonna keep smacking me. But I just blocked that. There we go. One more hit. And he's gone. Yay! Give me that item. So it's a bunch of the smithing stones, but it is worth getting because why not? So now we can go to where the giant was, and there's going to be a grace, and that's the final grace before the boss. Now don't worry about it right now because we are not going to fight the boss. There's several other things we still need to do, but let's go ahead and get the grace. And we're going to go this way because there was that elevator before. It's going to take us to the same spot, so it really doesn't matter. So let's hit the grace. And you can't even rest at it? I'm going to rest at it. And I would recommend resting at it, because we're not going to have to really deal with the giant or any enemies over there again. So we're going to go this way where there's this scarab. Let's go ahead and take him out. There's also a bunch of jars over here. First things first. Come here, you little scarab. And look at all the jars. There's a ton of them. There's a big one as well. He's getting up. He's mad. Killing all his babies. Okay. One Ash Award. No, I guess not. I was going to say one should take him out, but I guess it's two. He always will drop some items anytime you kill one of those big jars. Now, some of these jars aren't really doing nothing. So, if you want to be evil, you can kill them, but that's up to you. Pick up those items. And now, just real quick, I'm going to go double check to make sure there's no items over here. But I don't think there is. Because this is where the elevator would be, and this is where the elevator would take you. In fact, I can just send it down, why not? And now, let's go ahead and come back this way, kind of going towards where the boss would be. But we're going to do a little bit of a parkour. So there is an item right here, let's pick this up. And if we just jump right here, we can hug the wall. And you will need to jump over there, I can see the message, but just jump. And now we're in a little secret area. And there is a knight and there is also a bird, which is annoying. So let's try to get the bird mainly first. Hopefully. Nope. Oh, I got the knight with one hit. Nice. Awesome. Well, now I just gotta deal with the stupid bird. The way they move is what makes it so annoying to deal with the birds, in my opinion. I hate them. And it's so bad that I think that I hate the birds the most. And that's more than the dogs, which I hate the dogs. Like, the way they move is so annoying. But the birds are just terrible. Now, coming up, there's a bunch of dudes in this room. But we're going to just wreck them. But before that, actually, there's an item over here. So make this jump, grab this item, and jump again. And there's also, like, a couple other items coming up. But the room after that, there's a bunch of guys in there. They're all weak, though. There is a crafting material. Let's pick that up, too. But they're really weak. But this is where we're going to get our shield. And I'm going to upgrade it before we actually fight the boss. So in here, the first enemy we can take out is in this little room. So just take him out and look around, because I mean, they're all over the place. They're all kind of sitting down and stuff at first, but now they're starting to get up and they're trying to kill me. No. Oh, I'm missing all my attacks. It should probably lock on. Here we go. Bunch of guys over here. Take them all out. And then there's this dude. If you like drop down and grab the shield, or if you run like forward, they'll all get up and they'll all come after you. And that's where it's a little annoying. But that is our shield. That shield is really good. It can be better later on. We can actually interact with this, which I think that's the sorcerer. It's just like an NPC message to you. So go ahead and hit that if you want. But grab that item and then we can come down this way and just drop off. And just keep going. And there's going to be an item down here, which people always put messages down. It's really annoying. Our bloodstains. But let's see. Can I pick this up? I guess you're going to have to jump up. Pick it up. And now we can actually get this shortcut. Where that room was with the elevator and the grace, we can actually open up this door. And this will be a shortcut. So if you do die, you can actually come back to this grace and just walk out this door here. Because there is a boss. And again, I don't know what to call it. Because I want to say a mini boss. But it actually, I think it has a health bar. Oh, maybe it doesn't. I don't know. We'll see. But if it has a health bar, I guess I could say a field boss. But it doesn't make any sense because it's in the castle. So yeah, I don't know. Mini boss. That's what I'll say. So there was a bat there and an item. And there's another bat. There's actually two. Technically, we could probably try to get this bat by just like swinging. Okay, nah. They can poison you. That would be the one annoying thing right here, is that if they actually poison you, so watch out for that. But the bats are normally pretty easy to take out. There's no item in here, but there is going to be an item across. So you're going to want to go ahead and hop down here, make this jump, grab this item, jump again, and now we can walk on down. Now, remember before I said there was that one spot where you could hop down, but don't? Well, this is basically where that spot would take you, so that's why you don't want to go down there. And yeah, there's a bunch of rats. So there's some baby rats, and then there's going to be a mama rat. But then finally, there's going to be a papa rat. And man, this papa rat can be really annoying. Now, we're so OP that we are going to take him out no problem. But I really do believe that the secret to these enemies, and yeah, there is a scarab. This is a spell. It's hard to like see, but you could see that color. I've talked about this already before. There is a blue color scarab, which is the sorceries, where a lot of times they're the FP potion, so it can be a little confusing with the blue. Okay, so down here is where this boss is. The real secret is to try to stay close to him. I really feel like he has a real hard time hitting you when you're close. So just kind of hug the right over here. Let him come out first. And I should have actually buffed, but whatever. And I guess, yeah, he is a mini boss. He doesn't have like an actual health bar. I'm going to back up. He's going to explode. And yeah, he got me. But I need to also restore my FP. So if you could just stay like right up on him, a lot of his attacks will just miss you. It's crazy. We're so OP, he's weak, we destroyed him, no problem. So, we are basically just grabbing all the items down here. That mini boss did drop a golden seed, which is nice. And there is something very interesting down here. And that's going to be a blood stain. But it's actually a blood stain from that NPC. That's the crazy part. So if we actually interact with this blood stain, it's going to be that sorcerer guy. And to me, that looks like he's being cursed or death blighted in this game. So now that we've seen that, we can actually ask him about that. Now, the main purpose of it is that it kind of changes his quest a little bit. But you really just get some lore from him. That's about it. You don't really get any other rewards for doing that. But you do want to find that bloodstain. Now, at this point, we can climb up that huge ladder and get out of here. But there's no reason to, because we've already gotten everything. So instead, let's just go to the secluded cell and we're gonna go and fight this boss. And I'm gonna cut this ahead. I'm gonna see you guys in a moment. Alrighty, now I forgot about something. and that is I wanted to go and upgrade the shield. We got this new shield, and now this shield is really good, so we definitely want to upgrade it. I was able to get it all the way to +8, which is going to increase its guard boost. That's why you want to upgrade your shield. And because it's kind of heavy, we do need to try to figure out a way of still being in the mid load. So the Crimson Hood is a very good light helmet to put on. And for now, this is all I have that's really light to give me that medium load. So that's all I switched. But the main thing is that we will be able to actually continue to use heavy armor. We just need to level up our endurance a little bit more. And we also need to get a talisman. That's basically it. So we're not going to be looking like this in a moment. Like, we just won't. Okay, so now that we're here, let me also go ahead and switch the Ash of War on this, because I talked about this before. We bought this no-skill Ash of War, and we did it because we wanted to be able to actually take off the skill. That way, we can still use our Ash of War while blocking. Now, I'm going to summon this girl. You don't need to. She will help, though, to be fair, but you just don't need to summon her. And once she gets in here, I'm going to go ahead and buff her and me with Golden Vow, and then we are going to go fight this boss. So let's go ahead and use that up. And we're going to have to use an FP potion at some point because we will run out here. Alrighty, now I did forget to use my mix potion, so try not to forget that. And let's get on him. With this better shield, we should be able to block his attacks a lot easier. Whenever you feel like you got an opportunity, just go for your Ash of War. I got that free hit right there. The NPC is going to actually distract this guy for me a little bit. Out of FP, need to use my FP potion. And he is chopping off his arm. Now the moment the cutscene's over, rush him. Just rush right up to his face and he will miss you with that attack. And now we can do our Ash of War. And he's falling over. One more, he might be dead. And he is. So that's a GG for him. Thank you for the help, NPC. That is awesome. But now that he's done, he's going to talk a whole bunch. There's actually going to be that one guy. He's going to make an appearance here, the merchant. And at this point, we can't really do anything with him. I know later on there's something with his quest, but we also got his great rune. So now we can actually mess with that. I believe if we actually just light this grace and rest at it, this NPC will probably show up here. So let's just check this out real quick. So let's just rest and see. Is he here now? Yes, he is. So you can go ahead and talk to him. And he's brutal, man. Completely brutal. He's just stomping his head in. And he's mad. But yeah, just go ahead and talk to him. And I'm just making sure that he's repeating himself. And he is. So now let's go this way. There is an item that we need to get over here. And that's actually for another quest line. I talked about this in the last episode. And that is, we did a quest line at that side castle, and now it's going to open up another quest line. So that's the trigger for the quest, is that you have to do that other quest line at that side castle, which was the whole thing about go and deliver the note to the father, and then the girl died, and then he went, and he couldn't rescue her. It's very weird and confusing, because this NPC we're about to talk to is a different NPC, but looks just like the girl. So maybe it's connected, because she does die, but maybe she becomes a maiden? Because that's what this whole quest is about. This girl wants to become one of these finger maidens. So you gotta get that item over there, and once we come out here, this is where that grace is, and we've been had this for a long time, and we can see her already. And if you don't remember this spot, remember the church over there? That's where we got a secret tier. But we can go ahead and talk to her. And she's going to want that thing that we just picked up, which, guess what, is eyeballs. Very creepy stuff. And she eats them. But she's going to give you an emote, so let's talk to her again and make sure she's done. Okay, she's done. And now, let's go back to the round table, because there's something that we need to get there. And we are going to just go ahead. Remember, you can hit triangle and then square, and you don't have to, like, actually zoom out. But we need to get this one talisman. We can get it from that girl that we just summoned. And we also need to come into this room that just opened up. This is important for what we're about to do. So the room is over here. The door is now open. And we can actually talk to this NPC. Now look at that creepy fingers, man. It's so weird. Oh man, Miyazaki, bro. I don't get it. Like, he's got a crazy mind. But I love his games, don't get me wrong, they are awesome, but some of the stuff is just out of this world. But talk to this finger maiden thing, and I think that's what it is a finger maiden. And that's what that girl wants to become. Although I guess technically the girl that is our maiden, like, she's kind of normal. I don't know. But now that that's done, we can actually go get this max stone. We got one more upgrade stone to max out our weapon, and we can go and do it now. So over here, this door will open up now. You can talk to this guy, and he's going to give you a lot of information about all the great runes and a bunch of the bosses. But we can actually talk to this girl, and she's going to reward us. Now, it doesn't matter if you summon her or not. She's always going to do this. She's going to give you a talisman, the Arsenal Charm. That's going to up our equipment weight so we can actually equip heavier stuff. So hopefully that's going to help us a little bit because we are having some issues right now. And over here, there is this guy. You can talk to him. He's really got nothing to do right now. Later on, we can do stuff with him. And one of the things you can do, which I think I will do, is we're going to have a potion quest. And if you actually give him the potion, it kind of messes up his quest line. But what I've heard is that his, like, summon, where you can actually, like, summon, like, an ash, like the wolves, his summon is, like, the best right now. Or at least it's one of the best. I think I'm going to do that for the walkthrough because that's important for newer players to make the game easier, right? To have a really good summon. And if it's true that his summon is very, very good, I don't really care about his real quest. It's not even like that important anyway. But now what we can do is we need to actually come over to the lake because we're trying to get over here. This is the spot we're trying to go to. But before we go over there, let's go here. So right on the map, you have like these circle things. This particular circle thing is going to have a grace in it. So I'm going to start from here. I'm going to ride over there. I think I'm going to probably cut this ahead though, but that's exactly where we're going. And there should be a grace there. Alrighty, well, I'm coming up on the beacon now, and there is a grace here. So if you're just following your beacon, you're going to have no problems finding the grace. Also, I was able to re-equip my armor because I went ahead and put the Arsenal Charm on. And that allows me to put this Vagabond Knight armor on. Can't do anything with the helmet though because it's just too heavy. But like I said, the Crimson Helm, or hood, is very good. So I would recommend it. It gives you a couple more points in your vigor. So that's not bad at all. Now the reason why this grace is important is because we will have to come back here a couple times. But put your beacon right there where this church is going to be. And anytime we need to come back here, we're just going to go back to that grace and ride on over here. There is actually going to be an enemy, I believe, in the church. I'm not sure if this guy is actually going to prevent the enemy from being there. But if you remember, when we first started the game, there was that very first NPC on the first step grace. That's the moment we go into the open world. The very first grace is the first step, where there was this guy. He's the white mass NPC, and now we can talk to him. But you do have to talk to the finger thing. Remember that at the round table? You have to do that. And you also need to say that the fingers just didn't seem right. Now we can start his quest line. So once we talk to him again, he's going to give us some items for invading other players. And that's what we need to do. Now this part can be a little bit time consuming depending on what day it is, depending on like different aspects. Because we have to find people that we can actually invade, which can be kind of annoying. But in the open world, I think that's going to be your best chance. Because we have a +9 weapon. So we're only going to be able to invade other players that have a +9 or +10 weapon. That's it. Now normally that wouldn't be a problem because people are always PvPing. But we're also only level 50. So that's kind of the issue right now. The main thing is you don't have to actually do any PvP. That's a big part. I guess the enemy does spawn in here. So let's kill this enemy, because we just want to get this out of the way and done. And look at the block. You gotta love the block. It's so great. The Great Shield is so much better at blocking than any other shield in the game. Well, let's pick that item up. That's basically all that's like really in here. There are some enemies too. We can get the crafting materials as well. but we need to now invade players. And like I said, you don't need to fight. I'm not going to fight. I'm going to show you what I'm going to do. The moment I get into their world, if I connect, I'm going to use this item. It's going to return me back to my world. And the thing is that as long as you connect to the other player, now if you want to try to PvP, you can. If you win, that's fine. If you lose, that's fine. If you just return to your world with that item, that's fine. It does not matter how you actually do this, as long as you can connect. So we have to use this item, and we have to do this 3 times. So like this spot, I'm not going to get an invasion. If I sit here long enough, I probably will, but I'm going to try to go to different spots. The main spot I'm going to go to right now will maybe be the capital area. This might be my best chance of actually getting an invasion. And if not, the first step is actually not bad. People do PvP all the time over here, so that's okay. I know that like the biggest PvP spot is actually this, which is the main academy gate, but these are where duels are happening, so I don't know if you're going to be able to actually get PvP or not. But I'm going to go here, I'm going to try to get some invasions, and like I said, I'm just going to return back to my world. I'm not going to actually try to kill anybody, I'm not trying to be killed by anybody, I'm just returning to my world. So it's taking a minute, but I am getting an invasion right now, and I'm getting it at the first step. I definitely think that this might be the best spot. Just because there's always a lot of PvP going on here, and people might be on New Game Plus. But the moment that I load in, I'm just going to go to multiplayer, and I'm going to return to my world. That's it, and it counts as one of the 3 evasions that we need to do. Alrighty, well, I am done with the invasions. The first step was definitely the place to go. It did take a minute a couple times, but I was able to get my invasions in at the first step. But another thing too is that there is an emote you can get if you interact with the message that's right there. Where this white mask guy used to be, that's where you will get an emote. Once you're done with that, return back to the Rose Church and talk to him. I've already done this, but you need to tell him that you want to be anointed. And then he is going to tell you that you have to go get the blood of a maiden. Now to do this is actually fairly easy. We need to make our way over to the Grand Lift. Remember this spot? We already have the grace, that's not a problem. Now there is a church up here, and there will be a sacred tier as well, so that's nice. We're going to put a beacon there, and we're going to fast travel over to the Grand Lift. Now this is a little bit annoying because there's going to be a lot of madness in this area, but we will be able to handle it, no problem. So let's hop on the horse. And we are going to actually jump over here. You can also go down the steps, but it's just quicker to jump up here like this. The big thing is you may die. In fact, I should have leveled up. I really should have leveled up because you definitely can die here. There's no doubt. The madness is really annoying. There's going to be some items along the way that we're going to pick up as well. But there is a tower in front of us. This tower is going to be putting madness on us like crazy. So let's deal with the tower first so that we don't have to worry about it at all. But pick that up, pick this up, and you can see my madness is going up. My health is also being drained. At this point, if I want to just chill here, you can, and you shouldn't get any madness from this spot. So it's not a bad idea to let it go down. We also want to get that item over there too. But now we're going to rush the tower and hope that we don't get killed by these stupid rats. Now this madness tower, it like pulses, and when it pulses, that's when it's going to get the madness on you. Now the big thing up here is, one, we can take out that first one. There's a big one we want to try to get that. Oh my god, see, when you get madness on you, you get stunned. That's the annoying bit. So let's heal up, try to do our Ash of War. Okay, oh, that's lucky. You can definitely be killed by that giant rat, there's no doubt. Now we can climb up the ladder. There is a chest, we're going to open that and get the item now, that way we're done with this little spot. But we need to kill all of the guys up top, it's really easy though. So pick that up, it's a incantation spell for madness, which I call frenzy. I'm really confused on like what they want to call it in this game. It is madness, but at the same time, a lot of these places, this is called the frenzy tower. So it's just like, is it frenzy or is it madness? Same with like the village coming up over here. It's going to be called like the Frenzy Village. very confusing. Let's call our horse, and we're going to head down this way. You can see the wall. There is a village. We're not going to do it right now. We will eventually get to it, and we will clear it. In our next episode, we will start working on the lake area, and there's a lot to do there. A lot to do in the lake area. But you see what I'm saying about the whole frenzy village? Very, very confusing. But what we're looking for is we're looking for a path that leads up. So just pass all these enemies. There is a path. It goes up. And this is going to take us where the church is. Now the church, there's going to be this NPC invader, and we can run right past him, grab what we're looking for, and hit the grace. That's the main thing. We can hit the grace. We don't have to worry about fighting him. We will fight him, but if he kills you, you're going to spawn at the grace, which is a lot better than spawning all the way back at the grand lift. So just run for it. Ignore him completely, and we're going to run in here. First thing, honestly, hit the grace just in case he catches you and he kills you. He can put frenzy on you. That's the big thing. Our madness. Let's go ahead and grab that. That's the sacred tier. This is what we need to interact with for the quest. And now let's try to fight him. Watch out for that. Back all the way up if he does that, because if you're standing in that fire, it's going to put madness on you. So I'm just doing my Ash of War. Of course, I have no... That's not good. That's really not good. I have no FP. Watch out for that attack too. I'm so getting madness on me. Run away! Use that. And I'm going to heal again too. Heal! Get out of here! He has a great spear. And great spears are awesome. I love them. They're so good. One more hit and he should be done. Ha ha, no more for you. Goodbye. Now he also drops an item for that one girl. The one we just talked to. It's another one of those eyeballs. That one is a legendary though. So it's going to be a little bit later in her quest line, but we just got it now. And he also drops his great spear, which that's a really fun weapon. Very good weapon, too. But we are done here now, so we need to go back to the Rose Church. So let's go back to the Grace, make our way back to the guy, and talk to him. And he's going to give us an item that's going to teleport us to a spot that's like super endgame. But we are going to be able to get our final upgrade stone for our weapon in that spot. So I'm going to cut this ahead. I'm going to see you guys in a moment. Alrighty, well, I'm back at the Rose Church. Now I can talk to him, and he's going to grab my hand, and he's going to give you an item that will be a permanent PvP item, so you don't have to worry about using those consumables anymore. You'll have a permanent one if you want to invade players. But then the other item he's going to give us is a teleport item that's going to take us to this really hard spot. But we are just going to run past everything in this spot. We're not going to mess with it at all. This is actually like the best spot in the game for farming runes. So if you're trying to level up, you can farm this spot. It can be a little bit challenging unless you have like some crazy AoE or something. But in general, you can farm this spot if you're trying to level up like really quickly. There's also like ways you can use a bow to cheese it. So it's a really good spot. I'm not going to really go over that for the walkthrough. I might at some point. Let me know. Should I? Because I could really show you how to farm a lot of runes by using that spot. But now we're going to use this item and it's going to take us to where we're trying to go. And the main thing is we are just going to run past literally everything. Where we're going to spawn in, there's going to be a map and a grace. So we're going to grab those. And then we are going to book it right to the next grace and then we can get the stone. So the main thing is, let's hit the grace, just in case we die, which you can here. The first little part, though, is pretty easy. Also, put the lantern on. Just do it now so you don't have to do it later, because it's going to be dark coming up over here. So run past these guys. They're pretty passive, to be honest. Some of them are going to try to blow up on you. Watch out. Don't pick that item up, because why not? That's a 7 smithing stone. I'll take that. And just run right through all of them. There's going to be a giant blob coming up over here too. But the main thing is just go around it on the left. So there's the blob. Go around on the left. You can jump over. There is an item. Let's pick that up. Now let's just run for it. Bye-bye. See y'all later. Now there used to be a way to cheese this boss. And you could still technically cheese it. I don't really want to cheese any bosses though. I would not count the dragon as a cheese, the one I killed in the very first episode. It's really not a cheese. It's kind of intended that way. Now, that enemy, watch out. Make a right and keep going. We cannot stop. That enemy will destroy us. But this boss here, there was a legit cheese where you can jump over the wall and the boss wouldn't attack you. It was crazy, and you could get 560,000 runes doing this. It was really good. The problem is, like I said, even if I could, I don't really think I should for the walkthrough because of the fact that they're going to probably patch a lot of this type of stuff. Now, right there, that is a red summon sign for the white mask guy. That's a part of his quest. We're not going to mess with that right now, so let's just go ahead and rest here to de-aggro the enemies and all that. Now, what we're going to do is we need to be careful because these enemies are OP. They will murder you. So instead, we're going to go to the left. There will be an item back here, but we're going to draw the attention of the one big enemy, and then we're going to jump to where this chest is. It's very easy, to be honest. So grab the item here, and now the enemy's already trying to kill us, so that's good spot. We're going to jump on this, and then jump up, get to where the chest is, and now let's just open and grab it, and we're good. And basically, we can just run away. See you later! Kind of going the same way I went the first time, and just run right back to the grace and hit it, and you will be good. Now that we have that, we will now have a maxed out weapon, and that will be crazy. So the very first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and go back to the road to Manor. We're in the underground. I need to click R3, and we're going to go back to road to Manor, and we will go upgrade this weapon to +10. Now, in the future, if I want to switch weapons, which I think I might, I have seen a couple people make comments saying I should eventually switch. I might, but for now, I'm going to continue to use it because it's important for my walkthrough. But we are going to strengthen, and we will upgrade this to +10. So our damage is going to be just insane. It really will be. I mean, take a look at that. That is awesome. There's one last thing I want to do in this episode. I can't believe I was going to try to actually do all this in the last episode. Wow, that was a good decision to actually save it for this episode. We're going to go back to this tower bridge. Let's go and get our great rune activated. So, there are some items. I'm probably not going to grab them. I'm going to be honest because I remember them being fairly pointless and taking a very long time to get to. So we will grab that. That's a talisman. There's also some enemies on this bridge. You can kill them. They're fairly easy. With this weapon, they should be a joke. I guess I will. I don't remember there being items on this part of the bridge. There might be maybe one. But on the other bridge, there's like two or three items. But they are fairly pointless, if I remember. And you have to run like to the other side of the bridge. It's very annoying. Watch out for that stupid attack. To be honest, you can run past all this. The archer's the only kind of annoying one, because he could shoot you. So we're just going to run past. I'm just checking over here to the right to see, is there an item? Nope. All right, well, let's go ahead and rush the archer now. There might be one over there. If you just chill right here, though, we can wait. Oh, wow, he still got me with the AoE. So we're just going to rush, and the archer would be easy to kill. I think the archers are a joke. Let's just take a look. How much damage? Oh my god, yes. That's insane, the amount of damage he took. There we go. And yeah, there's no item over there. So I think that's it, really. The other side of the bridge, there are a couple items, and there's a bunch of those annoying birds, which you know I hate. So I don't know what they are. I know they're nothing like super important. To me, the purple items are the ones that matter, so those are the ones I'm going to try to definitely get. But yeah, if you go that way, where all the birds are, you can get yourself like a couple random, probably nothing items. But we're going to go in here now, and this is one of the Divine Towers. This is our very first one, and you have to find these if you want to activate these Great Runes. So I've talked about this before, and there was a place called like the Tower of Return. And that spot, there was no reason to do it really early because we don't have the Great Rune yet. And we will be going there at some point. We have this one. Let's go and activate this. Now, this Great Rune is definitely not bad. If you want to activate it, you have to use a rune arc. Now, if you're doing co-op or PvP, you're going to have a ton of these. Like, you will get these no problem. You can always activate them. If you're not doing any co-op and you're just doing single player, then they will be a little rare. But if you feel like you're not going to die a lot, there's no reason not to just use them. Why not? You know, if you're going to go to a spot that's really dangerous and you know you're going to die, you might not want to waste it there. But if you're in like a fairly normal spot and you are just dominating, especially because you're overpowered and you have a maxed out weapon, go ahead and use them. Because this particular one, let's pick it up first, it's going to give us +5 in every attribute, every single one. And that is nice. That also means that we can actually probably re-equip our armor and stuff, because we're going to get 5 endurance. The big one, though, to remember is that if you ever mess with your equipment load while having your great rune activated, this particular one, you do need to always keep that in mind, that maybe you don't have the right equipment weight. So now that little symbol is up there by our health and our FP and our stamina. If I use one of these, it's going to make it glow. And now all my attributes are up. My health is more, my FP is more, my stamina. And if I really want to, I could probably re-equip this and still have the mid load. So I probably will do that. But if I die, I'm going to be fat rolling. That's the one thing I'll have to try to remember. Alrighty, guys. Well, that's going to do it for this episode. I really do hope that you have enjoyed it and that this has helped. If it has, will you please like the video for me? And be sure to subscribe for future episodes of this series. If you do, though, make sure to click the bell. That way you can stay notified. Thank you so much for watching, and I really do hope that everyone has a very nice day. And peace out.